congratulations. Thank you so much. But I really don't know what to do about my education.
Yeah, same. Even I'm applying to universities and I don't know how to get my education.
But I think I can guide both of you and you guys can join as well. Hi guys, I'm Damini from WeMakeScholars. Very happy to share that we are launching this most comprehensive YouTube web series on abroad education loans called Loan Flix, Education Loan Simplified. So the motive is to make sure that every student gets to know their loan very well and takes an informed decision. So welcome to the first episode, and today I'm going to give you a sneak peek on introduction to education loans. So I'm going to cover four basic topics. So what is an education loan, types of education loans, non-collateral and collateral, and important terms, and when is the right time to apply for an education loan. First we'll start with the very basics. So what is an education loan? It is really simple. So education loan is a loan which a student takes to fund their education. So depending on the product, it can cover everything from your tuition fee to living expenses to travel expenses, even your books and health insurance. So let me tell you what are the different types of education loans. So basically, there are two types of education loans. First, a secured or a collateral loan. And second, yeah, you guessed it right. So it's a non-collateral or an unsecured loan. So collateral loan is the one in which you have to pledge a collateral or mortgage it to the bank to take a loan against it. On the other hand, there are non-collateral loans where no collateral or security is required. But a non-collateral loan takes other different parameters into consideration for offering your loan. So such as the primary factors are students' academic profile and which country you are heading to. And in addition, for applicants' profile, like whether they are your blood relatives and what is their financial profile and do they file income tax returns and things like that, these are the other secondary parameters they take into consideration. So here at WeMakeScholars, we are associated with both nationalized banks and NBFCs who offer you different loans like secured and unsecured. So we help students with both these kinds of loans. So let's discuss the important terms you will come across during your loan application and the complete process. So most important is collateral. So as I mentioned, collateral is something you pledge to the bank to take a loan against it. So there are two kinds of collaterals. We'll get to the details in the later video. So it's primarily movable properties like house, flat, land, or liquid securities like fixed deposit, LIC, policy and government bonds. Another term is co-applicant, co-borrower and co-signer. So all three are kind of same, used interchangeably. So it's a simple co-applicant is someone who pays for your loan if you are not able to pay, right? So in India, the primary accepted co-applicants are parents, parents-in-law, siblings, spouse and even relatives. Another term is moratorium period. So this is kind of a grace period you get before your loan repayment starts. So because when you take an education loan, during the course period, you cannot actually pay because you're not earning. So this grace period is usually your course duration plus 6 months or 1 year. So this kind of grace period, this moratorium period term is very unique to education loan because in case of personal loan or car loan or home loan, you actually start paying immediately after the loan starts. Another term is processing fee, which you will come across. So processing fee is simple, that's in every loan. That's a fee you pay to the bank for processing your loan. Just the difference is in case of government banks, you pay it while the process is going on. But in case of NBFCs for a non-collateral loan, you usually pay it after the loan is provisionally approved. So at WeMakeScholars, we at any point of time, we have offers running like full refund or partial waivers for the processing fee for almost all the banks. Another last term which I want to discuss is loan insurance. So as the term indicates, it's an insurance to cover your loan as and if something happens to you, the insurance company pays back your loan. So it usually covers death, permanent disability or serious medical issues. So it's very important to go through your loan insurance agreement before you pay for it. So now you must be wondering, when is the best time to start applying for your education loan? So generally it is always better to start collecting this whole information about education loan just after you are done applying to your universities. So I'm sure that most of you who are watching this video are done with that process. So the actual education loan process starts just like a week to 2 weeks before the expected date of receiving the admit, or just immediately after your admit is also fine. The most important thing is to make sure that you have enough time or buffer at each step, because we do come across applications where people come just 10 days before their visa date and they want a sanction. So that's obviously not something you should do. So there is a hack or jugaad which I'm going to share in every video. So it's kind of a trick which I learned on this journey. So hack for this video is, many people think that getting a home loan top up or a personal loan is much easier for funding their studies abroad. But you should always remember that education loan is your best choice, because it offers you a moratorium period of approximately 2.5 years, when you have to pay only simple interest, that also will be paid later. But in rest, all the loans which you go for, you have to pay compound interest, that also to be paid immediately. So very happy to share one of the recent reviews a student had written about us. So Mimi Mukherjee writes that this team is awesome. I got frustrated with the laid-back attitude of nationalized banks, but WeMakeScholars made the whole process a lot faster and hassle-free. Thanks a lot, guys, for your support. My advisor was Ruben, and he helped me throughout the process. Thanks, Ruben. So thank you, Mimi, for appreciating the good work. So I hope you found this video useful and it could give you a general idea about education loans. We plan to make this series as an in-depth resource for everything about education loans. So stay tuned for our next episode, which is going to be on what is a secured education loan, in which we will be covering everything about secured education loans, its rate of interest, its pros and cons, everything in detail. So please don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more such informative videos, and do like and share it with your friends if you found it useful. So good luck.
Don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell icon to never miss any updates from us.